What is the difference between unbleached and bleached flour? To answer that, we need to look at a grain of wheat. Wheat flour is made from the ground seeds of several varieties of grass, and these grains consist of three parts: a bran, germ, and endosperm. When wheat is milled, the different parts of a kernel are separated through several stages of rolling and sifting. The bulk of the kernel consists of the endosperm, which makes up around 85% of the kernel. This is the flour part of a grain of wheat. This part may also be sorted into different grades by the miller based on bran content. The outer layer of the kernel consists of the bran, which makes up about 13% of the kernel. The germ, which is the new plant part of the seed, makes up about 2%. Whole wheat flour includes all three parts of the kernel in the finished product. This is accomplished by grinding the kernels as a whole, as seen here, or separating the parts and recombining them again for the finished product. Whole wheat flour has a short shelf life, and this is because the fatty acids in the germ begin to oxidize as soon as it's ground. Depending on the storage climate, this typically results in the flour going rancid in less than a year. White flour consists only of the starchy endosperm part of the kernel. When freshly milled, the flour has an off-white color. This is unbleached flour. Typically, unbleached flour will be aged to allow the pigments in the flour to oxidize, which will whiten the flour's color. The aging process also improves the flour's baking properties, and this can take several months. Bleached flour skips the aging process altogether. Instead, the flour will be treated with a bleaching and maturing agent. The bleaching process is frequently accomplished by using benzoyl peroxide. A secondary maturing agent may also be used to change how gluten develops when it's converted into a dough. Some producers may use chlorine gas as both a bleaching agent to oxidize the starch and a maturing agent to weaken gluten development. The end result of the bleaching process is the whitest flour with a fine grain and soft texture. Both bleached and unbleached flour may be enriched with additional nutrients to restore some of the B vitamins and iron that were lost when the bran and germ were separated from the rest of the grain. And that is the difference between whole wheat, unbleached, and bleached flour.